Welcome to the Doubleheader. Happy Friday. I am not Hari Sreenivasan, but I am here to talk about the politics of sport and the sport of politics with David Brooks, Mark Shields, our Friday regulars. Hari is off getting married, and then we'll be on his honeymoon, so you'll have to get used to me for a little bit longer. And Mark and David, thank you very much for being here. First things first, the sport of politics. Michele Bachmann, not seeking re-election. How do you feel about this?
Deeply disappointed. Now, she gave a talk on... First, Hari will be glowing even more than normal. That's what strikes me.
That's right.
So she gave a little speech online, I guess, just a YouTube-type deal, with dramatic background music. That was very important.
Quite long, actually.
Quite long.
Yes.
It was. If Lincoln had had that at Gettysburg, somebody would have remembered that speech.
Yeah, absolutely right.
And of course, she bashed the media, which is ironic, because she was mostly a media creation. That she ran for the House leadership at one point, mm-hmm. or a leadership position, and didn't really have all that much support.
Gave the Tea Party response to the State of the Union
Did that, looking in the wrong direction. But she was mostly a media thing, and so she was important for a few moments, but I'm not sure she was much of a legislator.
She also ran for president, Mark.
She ran for president. I confess that I overestimated her. I was at Ames, the Iowa State University, the Republican straw poll, which she won. August of 2011, and there are two kinds of politics. There are retail politics and wholesale politics. And wholesale politics is somebody who can, over television or in a large audience, at a stage, command a crowd. And she was very impressive that way. She really was. Where she died was in retail politics, in small, I mean, answering questions. She was not, in other words, as long as she was performing, she was awfully good at it. And there was an electric quality about her. She was she was an emphatically appealing woman and attractive. But when she was being questioned, just, you know, in a straight conversation, there was just a sort of unease and an awkwardness about her. She sponsored 58 pieces of legislation in the House, has up to now, and passed one, and that was the repeal of the Affordable Care Act. Passed the House, which is going
passed
nowhere.
Passed the House multiple times.
Yeah. That's right. Yeah. But I mean, so, you know, Dave is right. She was not a legislator. But she and Sarah Palin, to me, and maybe you could help me on this, Christina, I think there was a certain appeal to the supporters that we have very attractive, intelligent women as our faces.
Not to mention moms, right? They both
and
tried
moms,
to
no, no, exactly.
Moms,
I mean, she was, and yes, I mean, to her credit, I mean, she had, 17, 18 foster children.
Yeah,
I think 23 in all, wasn't it, with their own five. I mean, so, wow, I mean, that's pretty impressive.
Now to the politics of sport. David, you were very excited. The Mets beat somebody this week.
They beat the crosstown, as my newspaper kept saying, the more prestigious rivals, the New York Yankees.
They
like,
what a elitist
prestigious among who?
Yeah.
I know. My newspaper covers the Yankees column after column. The Mets get a little paragraph like we're in Dubuque. So they swept them four games in a row. Some outstanding pitching performance from Matt Harvey, who is the best pitcher in baseball, according to me, and Dylan G, who had a great outing. So it was to beat they're having a lousy season, but to win that four games, that'll be possibly the highlight, unfortunately.
It was wonderful, and for all those who are in that large community of Yankee haters, it's a very positive. It's not a negative. It's a very positive. We toast the Mets. We salute the Mets. We appreciate the Mets. We honor the Mets.
Thank you.
Will LeBron be going to San Antonio tomorrow night? Final game of the playoffs here.
This has all the markings of a seven-game series to me. It really does. Indiana really should be ahead 3-2 at this point, at the least. And last night, there's no question LeBron was dominant. But, an Indiana-San Antonio final is probably not what David Stern, the commissioner of the NBA, has in mind.
But I do think people are rooting against the Heat.
Yeah, they are.
It's like the Yankees. And and it is true, if you can get some big guys like this, I forgot his name now, Hibbert from Georgetown.
Roy Hibbert. Boy, he has really developed. He's become a dominant force. Yeah. But LeBron is not, LeBron's sort of Derek Jeter. I mean, it's tough to dislike him personally.
Right.
I mean, you got to have a real hate.
Unless you're in Cleveland.
Right.
Yeah, unless you're in Cleveland or Akron. That's right.
Well, I'll do my best Hari impression. Thanks, guys. And please, you guys will see us all again next Friday. But very important, June 21st, we will be doing a live doubleheader with Mark and David and Hari. Make sure to stay tuned for that. Lots more to come on that. Happy Friday.